Hello and welcome to this week's podcast. We are going to be talking all Halloween this week. We decided it would be a fun chance to get into the history of Halloween, how different cultures maybe celebrate their similar style of Halloween, and our own Halloween experiences, because I know I have some pretty funny stories. So let's get right into it. So we're going to start with the history of Halloween. And so Halloween originated in Salem, as many of you know, Salem, Massachusetts. And essentially, it was a political rivalry between two families. The first family's name was Paris, the father's name, and we don't have the second family's name. So we're just going to go family Paris and then other family. I feel like that's a good distinction. So family Paris recently moved into Salem Village, and they were a pretty dominant family. And then the other family was also just as dominant. So there was a lot of political rivalry in wanting to do things a certain way, wanting to run the church a certain way, trying to run the government a certain way, and that led to like a lot of conflict. So something happened in Paris's families where his daughters began to experience hysteria and began to get sick a lot, and then they would become like hypnotized almost and like taken by the devil. And the daughters began to blame it on the fact that their slave would tell them stories of witches and wizards and the devil. And that slave, you know, got in a lot of trouble and was taken to court along with a couple other women known for telling stories of witches. And they were put through trials where other witches, quote unquote, would soon come out and be like, yeah, me too, I was a witch. The whole thing, the whole nine yards. And they went through lots of trials until the first woman, she was hanged at Gallows Hills, and that was the first execution of a quote-unquote witch. And our last execution of a quote-unquote witch actually happened in Switzerland in 1782. So we've had hangings of witches from the 1600s to the late 1700s. This was like after America became its own country, which is kind of wild to think about. So that's the history of the witches. And then after that, we'll have Alyssa get into how it became more of a Halloween-y thing.
Halloween, the celebration of Halloween, can be traced back to ancient Celtic festival known as Samhain, which was held on November 1st in contemporary calendars. It was believed that on that day, the souls of the dead returned to their homes, so people dressed as costumes and lit bonfires to ward off spirits.
Oh, is that the same thing with, like, jack-o'-lanterns to, like, ward off spirits and stuff? Oh.
Yes.
Oh. Okay, then how did witches come into play specifically in America? And, like, why is Salem such a big part of American Halloween?
Well, Salem's where they first did the witch trials and, like, the hanging mm-hmm. of the witches. And so Americans are like, whoa, this is creepy. This is cool. Let's associate this with this creepy holiday.
That's very interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm actually learned about the Salem witch trials in my U.S. history class. It was crazy because people who didn't like other people, they would say, they are cursing me. Like, they would go on the floor and start spazzing out. And they would be like, oh my gosh, they cursed me. And then they would have this person that they didn't like hung for whatever reason that they don't like them.
Well, they did trials before that. I know one of the trials was they went and they made them strip to their garments and they looked all over their body to check for like a dark spot, and they would get something like a needle and stab it. If it bled, you would be regular and go on to the next trial or something. But if it didn't bleed, they would hang you because that's considered a witch's spot. And, you know, witch, hang them.
I read about that. They would put them through like these extreme trials that essentially no one could get through.
Oh, like drowning too, right?
Yeah. If you drowned, you're a human. If you didn't,
like, if you drowned, you're a human. And oh, well, they get. I guess we just killed somebody. But if you lived, you're a witch, and then they hang you.
Yeah, it was
like
whack.
Like, how can that be a trial? Either you die or you die. You know, that doesn't make any sense.
Next trial.
Okay, so what do you guys think about candy corn?
I love candy corn.
I'm kidding. Wait, I actually expected, like, everybody to hate it.
Yeah, I know. I thought
I really like candy corn, too.
I love candy corn.
Yeah. Okay, well, I thought that was going to be more controversial, but kind of an interesting fact, candy corn is called candy corn, not because it tastes like corn, but basically a company actually created it and called it chicken feed, you know, because how chickens used to eat corn. Right. Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, they still do, but yeah, I'm talking about like farms,
chicken feed,
rural places.
With a D? I thought you said feet. Yeah, like feet. Lisa and I looked at each other and we're like, feet?
Tasty.
Yeah. Well, that's an actual, no, thank you. That's an actual candy. Maybe I'm remembering it wrong, but it's like
yeah, it is. I think so.
Yeah, but isn't it, is it in Spanish or something like that? Well, I don't know.
I think they're gummies.
No, it was. It's like a stick of something. I don't know.
Maybe that's like a,
do you know that candy? It's like, it's, it looks like those, like Slim Jim's sausages, but it's actually like a candy. And it's something chicken. I don't know why.
Is it like they have like a stick and it's like a very thin layer of, I don't know, melted
it's
sugar?
It's like a, I don't know. I literally, it's one of those candies that I grew up with and I literally just accepted that it tasted good and didn't question why or what it was called. So I literally don't know.
Chico stick.
Yeah. What, I think my dad called it chicken stick. Bro? I don't know why.
Chico stick.
This is so good.
They're skinny. Like yeah. Those stainless sticks.
Yeah, they look like, they kind of look like little chicken legs. Anyway,
moving on. Yeah, that was kind of a fun fact about candy corn. But, like, a lot of people don't like it, so yeah. I was really expecting
that. I thought you were going to say the thing where if you stack candy corn all together, it looks like corn.
I think that's why the company, like, they made it look like corn and called it chicken feed, so it was, like, popular for Halloween, you know?
It'd be cool if they just sold it as the corn.
Yeah, that would be smart. They could put, like, a little thing in the middle to keep it in that position. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. They're not creative enough.
Like, also, I feel like
that's the shade. Okay, well, now I'm gonna go more in depth on like when candy was popular. At first, I think it was just like treats, like pastries, and like, cause you know, candy wasn't commercialized all the way back then, right? So in the 1900s, 1920s to like 60s is when candy became more popular for like trick-or-treaters, and they would give out little candies, caramels, pastries, I think a cookie. Yeah, like a cookie. And I think that they had little circle cakes called soul cakes, and they would give that to children. It was just when candy was popularized. Uh-huh. It wasn't, because it wasn't always that way.
Right.
And tricks, of course, you know, the pranks. Always gotta have the pranks.
Darn teenagers.
But I bet they were, like, way worse back then. Actually harming people.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Because, you know, like, they didn't have, like, protection laws for, you know, basic
yes,
human.
Murder, the best prank.
I don't like you. She's a witch.
Mm-hmm. I feel like it was more than just TPing a house, though. It was also, like, worse.
Mm-hmm. Aren't you, like, not supposed to have black cats out during Halloween or something?
Oh, it's so dangerous.
Mm-hmm. Wait, what happened? Do people, like, kill them? Yeah, because, like,
It's definitely a thing. So what happened was, many homeless women identified as, like, witches because it, you know, it feels powerful to call yourself a witch. Like, you were the controller. You were, like, one with nature, to say. That's what they believed, right? So a lot of black cats would hang around these homeless women, and they became associated with witches and magic, and they came with a negative connotation. So having a black cat meant that you were going against the flow, you were a witch almost. And many people didn't like that because they grew up with Christianity and they grew up in a Christian household, so it was scary for them, right? So what they would do is they would take these cats and they would harm them. And even today, like, it's very scary to leave, like, have a black cat out in public. They're saying, like, this Halloween especially, make sure your cats are inside. It doesn't even matter which color at this point. Make sure your cats stay inside, because if someone sees it and they believe in that negative connotation, they will harm them. Okay, well, let's talk about something a little...
Yeah, let's talk about a little...
Okay, so now we're just kind of going to go around and talk about what we would normally do, like our ethnic backgrounds, like what we would normally do on Halloween if we do something similar to Halloween. So I'm from Puerto Rico, and since it's an American territory, it's not really that different. Like, it's basically the exact same thing as in the States. It's just people are, like, the tiniest bit more superstitious, I feel. I mean, that's kind of it. We just go around trick-or-treating what you're used to here.
Well, what kind of, like, candies do you guys have there? Like, same candies or different?
It's pretty much the same, except for Chico Stick. We have that. That's a big one, bro. I love that one. Maybe it's just me, though. I don't know.
I don't think I've ever tried that.
Yeah, because, like, Mexico and Puerto Rico, we have very different candies. Like, the first few years, well, I mean, still, it's only 6 years or 7 years. But, like, specifically the first two, like, a bunch of my Mexican friends would come up to me with, like, their candy. And, like, they'd be like, oh, my God, this is like the best thing ever. And I'm like,
it's always the spicy candy.
Yeah,
that's the best.
And I don't like spicy candy. So it sucked. They were like, look at all of this candy I got. It's so good. And it's like from Mexico. And I'm like, I'm not Mexican and I don't like spicy candy.
You're like, two for two. Like,
yeah. I don't really know a lot off the top of my head that were specific to Puerto Rico because I moved when I was like 9. So my memory ain't that great. But I know that two of my favorites that I remember vividly, other than like, you know, Milky Way, Twix, the usual stuff for here and like Skittles or whatever, are the Chico Stick that I mentioned earlier. And this is actually still one of my favorite candies. It's called Vaca Lechera. And I think that specifically might be just the caramel. There's a bunch of different brands, but caramel is a big one that they don't do as much here because I feel like here it's more
grandma candy.
Granny candy, but
it's still good.
Yeah, because here it's more like hard and it tastes stale. But I mean, not all of the caramel candy is good in Puerto Rico. I know that I was like one of the few kids that liked it too, but it's just better. Like, when I got here, I was like, oh my god, I'm so excited. I got a bunch of caramels. And everyone was like, I don't want that. And then I tasted it, and I'm like, never mind, I see why.
Yeah, I don't want that either. Yeah. Well, I'm Mexican-American. I'm not from Mexico. I was born in Texas. But I do know a lot of the culture because, you know, Mexican. But in Mexico, they celebrate Dia de los Muertos, which is Day of the Dead, and they celebrate it on November 1st. And in Mexico, it's more of a day of celebrating your loved ones and they can come back. Not really like, no, stay away. It's like, yes, come towards us. They have ofrendas. If you watch Coco, you would know. But they have ofrendas and they put pictures and their like favorite food and stuff they loved in life. And they put that on there and they, you know, put the rose petals on the ground because that leads them towards the house. And they have a big feast. And I know they decorate the graves of the ones that have passed with food, candles, and a whole bunch of candy. And yeah, I don't think they go around trick-or-treating. It's more of a day for family, but I go trick-or-treating.
Yeah, I'm not sure if Puerto Rico has something similar because I feel like it's not the Day of the Dead. I know for a fact that we don't celebrate the Day of the Dead, but I feel like basically half of my family is super religious and the other half is 50-50 non-practitioners. So I was raised more by the non-practitioner side. So I'm not exactly sure, but I'm pretty sure some part of my family like took Halloween as more for honoring the dead rather than just fun costumes and candy.
I am from South Asia, like a mix of like India, Pakistan, Bangladesh. Literally got all three in my blood. I am surviving and thriving. Anyways, so we don't really celebrate Halloween because we're very careful about our dead and how we portray them. But we do very much believe in jinns and a lot of superstitions. So what jinns are pretty much souls or spirits with bad intentions. And they like to hang out in trees, specifically really big trees, like the oak trees here. We're like scared of them. I'm proud of it. So our thing is, especially at night, you never want to walk under a tree because the jinns kind of just hang out there waiting for you to like pounce onto your soul pretty much and give you the bad intentions that they have. So we're very careful about hanging around like trees at night. And so like that's like our thing, I guess, relating to the dead.
That's like, I'm actually going to like watch out for that now. Now that I think about it, because I do walk around at night with my family. I'm Japanese. Oh, I'm half Japanese. And in Japan, honestly, Japanese people don't necessarily celebrate Halloween. Yes, they might sell like Halloween merchandise that's like, oh, this is American, you know, very cool American holiday. Here, it's kind of like romanticized. I mean, sometimes Halloween-themed stuff is, like, sold in a little section at, like, the 7-Eleven or Lawson or whatever. Otherwise, they don't celebrate Halloween. And I was saying, like, this earlier, but some of my friends are like, oh, did you get presents from Santa Claus? And I'll be like, yeah, like, he came on Christmas. And they're like, he didn't come to me. Like, he didn't come to me. Yeah, but basically, they just don't celebrate many, like, American holidays. I mean, like, you may think that it's, like, global, but, like, I don't know. My parents, or my mom, just thinks American holidays are a waste of money. Like, she's like, Christmas is such a waste of money, like, and we have to give candy to all these random kids. Yeah, that's her ideal.
Is there something that is around the same time or like maybe something fall related that happens?
They go like leaf watching where like they see the autumn leaves and stuff like that. I guess that's kind of like a fall activity.
That sounds peaceful.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like, and you know, like the cherry blossom, you know, people go look at the cherry blossoms and lily pads and whatnot. It's so nice. It's so peaceful. And
that's
like,
really cool.
Yeah.
Now we're gonna talk about some stories, some experiences we have encountered on Halloween, around Halloween, just Halloween in general. I guess I can start with my story. I don't know how true this story is or how much of it I remember. But when I was younger, I'm a very social person, and I was a very social baby. And I was friends all the kids, all like the parents, all like the people in my neighborhood.
I can imagine, baby, at least.
I went to this person's house, and they had like this really big golden retriever that I guess I was friends with at one point, or something or the other happened. But on Halloween, this dog started running after me. I don't know what the deal was, but like I was getting candy from the lady, and all of a sudden the dog like runs out and starts coming at me. So I'm like little Elise, like 5 or 6, running around in an Aurora dress. Like, I don't know what's going on. And I was scared for my life. Okay, candy in hand. I was not letting go of that. Candy in hand. Yeah,
you
gotta
have the candy.
Honestly.
You got betrayed. You got betrayed by a friend. Of course you would call the dog your friend.
But like, I guess the dog was just really excited to see me, and I just wasn't expecting it to, like, come for me, because I was, like, the same height as the dog.
So dude, I hated big dogs.
Yeah, anyways, anyone have any other stories?
Oh, I have a funny story. This was in 7th grade, but my friend was, like, obsessed with Starbucks. She loved Starbucks. She had a Starbucks-themed birthday party.
Oh, my God.
Like,
oh, my God.
Yeah, so basically, we wanted to do our Halloween costume together, and
Starbucks cups?
Yes, she decided to be Starbucks cups.
Oh, my God. And I wish I wasn't right.
Yeah, but it was terrible. But we ended up having a fight on the same day, so we didn't end up going trick-or-treating together. So I had to be a Starbucks cup. And then next year, in 8th grade, we were Cher and Dion from Clueless. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
And we got in another fight.
Oh, my gosh.
And we didn't end up doing anything for Halloween together. So it was just, like, these 2 years in a row where we dressed up together, we got in a fight, and then didn't do anything for Halloween.
Dude, just go to Walmart, buy a witch hat, and go by yourself. Like,
yeah. But literally, yeah, but I just thought that was funny because we're fine now, but like the middle school.
I can imagine like two different neighborhoods, you see like the same Starbucks cup just like walking by, and you're like, am I seeing double? Like, is something messing with me?
Yeah, but that was just like, come on now, a Starbucks cup, like, oh my God.
Well, okay, I haven't really gone, like, legit trick-or-treating a lot. One of the last two Halloweens, I went with a friend in this, like, bad My Hero costume.
Don't talk to me no more. Don't talk to me. That's the last straw. That is the last straw.
Bro, I'll choose the second. I'll say it was 2 years ago so you don't hate me as much. But, no, it was literally the worst thing ever. I should have just, like, grabbed a skeleton t-shirt
Who'd
and walked out the door.
Who'd you go as?
The one with the little...
The thing?
Yeah, Jack girl. So when I was, I had to have been like probably no older than 7 or 6. My mom used to work at GameStop, so we would always get those discounts. We would get those cool Funko Pops that nobody wanted. It was like in a little strip mall, so I would just like go with her from store to store, and we would like get candy, and then whenever we were done or before we went, I would kind of like get into the drawers at the bottom of like the register and just like take all of the candy. Because what I mean by, like, the first time I had, like, a proper trick-or-treating experience here in Texas was because that was the first time that I had, like, gone basically alone. My parents were, like, around, but they weren't, like, breathing down my neck. It was me, my friend, and my brother. We, like, went around my neighborhood and, like, did, like, proper trick-or-treating.
I almost fought somebody on Halloween because they scared me. It was a grown man. There was this one house. There was this.
A-okay.
I was smaller. I was feisty. I'm just going to say that. There was this one house we always would go to, and there was this one man. He always did it. He got, I guess, a cut up, like, aluminum foil pan. He got a piece of that, and he scraped it across the sidewalk, and it creates sparks. It was our first time going, and so whenever we went, walking up the driveway, nothing. He was wearing all black. We couldn't see him. So we were walking, and he comes up behind us, scrapes it, see the sparks, and I start kicking and screaming. Because, you know, tiny me. Tiny me was weird.
Tiny was about to fight a grown man.
What are y'all most proudest, like, costumes?
Hopefully I do better this year, but it was, like, a rainbow.
Rainbow Dash costume. Oh my god.
Literally the only times I've worn a wig for an extended period of time. Like, I've worn, like, 3 times in my life. And it's a ugly rainbow wig. It looked like Scene. Almost. Ew. It looked like an unstyled Scene wig. And oh, wait, no. I just had, like, my cheap little, I had, like, rainbow stockings and my cheap little Rainbow Dash outfit. Because I was obsessed with Equestria Girls.
Oh, my God.
So,
That
was my thing. That was my thing.
Like, the songs had no reason to be that good.
Yeah, literally,
just saying.
So, last year was, like, my most favorite, but I sewed a Nightmare Before Christmas dress. You know, wait, what's
oh
her?
Oh, my gosh.
What's her name again?
Sally.
Yeah. I sewed a Sally dress, and then my boyfriend was Jack the Skeleton.
Ooh.
So we did like kind of like a duo costume.
Oh my gosh.
Mm-hmm. And that's
I
probably
it would be the Starbucks
I hate
cup.
You. That's literally
the
perfect.
Literally the Starbucks cup.
Are you serious?
Favorite.
Okay, but notice how I did not think of that costume. Like, don't put that blame on me, okay? Please.
Oh my gosh.
Blame the friend.
But yeah, and it took me like 2 hours or so right before Halloween, like the day before.
Oh my gosh.
But yeah, it was like pretty sick.
My favorite costume was my last year costume, which was probably my most expensive costume that my parents have bought for me. Since it was Corona and, you know, like, I decided to go with the theme of the year Corona. I was a plague doctor, and
oh, yeah.
It was eighth grade. Nobody wanted to talk to me. they were scared of me.
Well, actually, that makes sense, but that's cool.
Oh, I read play all.
Yeah.
My bad. Besides, like, the run of Disney costumes, I think my most favorite was last year, actually, during, like, COVID. I went with one of my best friends. She dressed up as a ladybug, and I dressed up as, like, a hippie. Like, I had, like, the denim jacket and, like, the thing, and then the big flowy, like, pants and, like, a really bright t-shirt.
Bell bottoms.
Not exactly. I thought they were bell bottoms, but they're more just, like, really
just, like,
big pants, like, flare pants. Anyways, so my favorite part, I took a photo, and my favorite part was that the moon was, like, right there. Like, the moon was, like, right above me, but there
just
was, like,
real
clouds.
Like, novel.
The moon was, like, but it was, like, a full moon, too. Like, last Halloween was a full moon.
And from the clouds.
And I became a werewolf. But so, and then the clouds were, like, it was cloudy that night. It was cloudy everywhere except for where the moon was. And the clouds were, like, broken up. And so it looked straight out of a movie scene. And it, like, reflected onto the, there was a lake in my neighborhood. So there's, like, it reflected onto the lake. And it looked so cool. And it's literally my favorite picture of my Halloween costume to date. Anyways, I think that's all we have on Halloween. I hope y'all enjoyed. I know we definitely enjoyed learning that. We have some pretty interesting stories and life experiences with Halloween. I hope y'all enjoyed. And don't forget, Halloween is on a Sunday. So, you know, make sure you wake up for school the next day, because school is, in fact, still the next day, unfortunately. So I think that's all the stories we have. So I hope that y'all enjoyed our little episode. I definitely learned about a few life experiences and new candies that we have. Chico sticks. Anyways, so before we end, Amelia, you want to shout us out?
Okay, our Instagram is CollegiantCastCA. Okay, and our Twitter and TikTok is CollegiantCast without the CA.
And I hope y'all have a safe Halloween. Have fun. Have lots of candy. And we'll see y'all next time.
Bye.
Bye.
Wait, why do we wave?